name is Pendapala Nakathingo, one of the community leaders of Ondonga.
Mr. Nakathingo, thank you very much for joining us in the Villager Studio today. We would like to start off with you telling us what is it that is happening in Ondonga.
Thank you very much. What is happening in Ondonga? It's something that most of us we never experienced before. And what is happening there, it is something that really needs to be addressed at a different level. Yeah,
Alright. Mr. Nakathingo, can you tell us how these troubles that are, or these challenges that are currently being faced in the community of the Ondonga people, how did these challenges come about, or how did these troubles come about?
Well, maybe I cannot really call it trouble. By saying challenges, yes, that can be correct. Because this are the challenges that faced the entire Ondonga community. And some of us, we were not really involved in a traditional authority, but we were just an ordinary community members. And we have been following these issues for quite some time now. It's whereby we as the well-informed community members, in, especially in that of in traditional activities and the national activities, we find it necessary to rescue the situations, because if we ourselves as the community members of Ondonga traditional authority cannot involved in the issue that facing us entirely, nobody else from outside can come and solve this problem for us or to solve these challenges that are facing us. So, but ourselves have to consciously and cautiously attend to that matters. So, uchahike, o zakati munoetu ala muno, nenge munoata lera oshigwana shandonga, kakuna mutea uke uthe poke ishichene. Numuwa asho, chene nando kasha nangu tamiko pipano, kandirinana merema, oshigwana shandonga. Ashike umkwashi wana ashike wawara nde o akwashi wana ngamba tarandula tarandula nge thimbo mainyengo kakakaji ni Ondonga na paka muna kutotashi ume neko kule one paka kuse tokoro nunga tunjono kucha na tuyambuke tutare kucha unku nungu wini nge Ondonga utatu kutare lingini na tatu kusa pongi.
Mr. Nakathingo, can you tell us what is the morale of the Ondonga community at this point? Do they still believe or do they still have confidence in the leadership in Ondonga?
Let me put it this way. The entire community of Ondonga, they are the community that are well informed in principles of their basis in terms of ethics and traditions and the tradition and norms. They are well informed. They know what are those norms and traditions and how to apply them. By saying if they still have got confidence in their traditional leadership, of course yes, we still have got our king. And we believe in our king. He's our king. Irrespective of these circumstances that arise. By having mentioned some few words of that nature, You know, there is a total confusion when it comes to the traditional leadership currently in Ondonga. The issue that is at hand, the king have got his own traditional counselors that are always, you know, steering the leadership and, you know, executing whatever need to be done in Ondonga. But there comes another challenge faced with those traditional counselors, known as Omalenga. You know, the king of Ondonga, traditionally, is the head of the entire community. Now, what prompted us, even some of us, to come in is an allegation of the involvement of the wife of the king. So now, some of them, and maybe she have used the opportunity, being the king, so getting old, or was driven by any other interest. So as I'm speaking now, there's a total confusion when it comes to the traditional leadership. This one are accusing the other, this one are taking, I mean, chasing the other out, and you know, those kind of things.
Alright. Mr. Nakathingo, the people that you have mentioned or the people that you are referring to who have replaced the senior leaders who have been expelled from the Ondonga Traditional Authority, the people who have replaced those leaders, what are their current intentions for the Ondonga community?
Well, I really cannot speak on their behalf. But what I can say is, it is uncommon practice to just replace, especially a traditional authority leader, just on your own, without being shown or being presented to the community that you are going to lead. So as I said, things that are happening or that happened in Ondonga currently, it is out of our experience. Therefore, you see there are disputes, and some of the disputes are in court that we cannot represent currently or speak on their behalf. But by saying the new leadership or the new people that have, you know, expelled the other one, the others out, or the other one which was voted out also. What I can say is that traditionally, the king is the one who appoints his traditional councillors and present them himself or personally to the community that they are going to lead. That is a traditional process or procedures. Yeah, so kuchake maringangagamo ningakuta mama kwao utaka ningingasha washitanga ningi ndita ndipo pita ndia popileko ningi ndipoza peka jao tani poza shkini kucha shima shita shini mungunoka shika kutu kucha katu shishinari ukwa cha wa shashmono afeke umu kwe pandero jo mkwaniyo kilo wako kwa maringangagamo mkwaniyo tutulama tutulama nene it's just like you overthrow the king's leadership. Then those are the things that master things that are happening in Ondonga.
All right. Well, mentioning on the current senior leaders, then would you say that those senior leaders are legitimate leaders?
Procedurally, as I mentioned before, you have to be presented in terms of traditional process. You have to be presented to the nation that you are going to lead by the king, if in that traditional authority or leadership there is a king. So currently, I never saw it happened anyway after these circumstances arose. I never saw it any village. I have just heard somebody say, or some, you know, the community in the community, or the self-appointed. I can call them self-appointed because when it happened, when they came in the office, apparently they just came and say, "Move out." We never saw it happen before, mm-hmm. And we are not to say they are the leader, and because they are not even vetted by the government, they are not endorsed, because those leaders have to be endorsed and recognized by the government. Yeah, or shall we pano or my number one tango sigo pano shindishi kare nu themba oku kare rapo nengi oku mkumato kromo shimo moshandonga otanti shipopi ndinu ukwenge. Yeah, more kwa chambo na kucha. She o time de non papia da sala da tata da sala com companhia e tu apoca stambe e ca fabrica tingo e tu apo da stambe son companhia a veta si tushi in terms of the law ngere on tuta da stambe o kuna kara ngauta ni ngere ran dishi o kuna kara en u kwacha ushike paveta. Wakara woshaina ngashingei hatku akuni bane gano kuchane umpandiro wa ndonga nenge tumba nenge ngati okuzane sulino jo tumba jo mwezi uni umvonguno itakara we hashaina ngashakara hashaina muru kwacha wan omoro tumba muru lema omoro kupe omoro matopero na kutuba. But the person bondi na tumora nando declare she may be now. Sigo pompa. Number one show. Nga e uye vede onzi wakara wa tukushu kwa shindongo ndiguna. Nga isheo nda kutuka papa nino. Nda te kwa papa nino. Ya number one show. O pethi bondi no. Unfortunately. Ya otatu unga nasho. Oyo elipo. natrenatavo trushigena kuwanza shokwa to naisha nayo weli onga oshitopura sha kwashigwana oshimbo sha ndonga ngiro pene puko tatu kongwa ropito tu vurenga na tatu kumila tana na rashi nisiko mami atu kopcha nayo ya nde o nayo ya kwato wangu moshi mungu maa kwa shiwana wa shiwana wa shantonga una papa kumbuwa mai kati huku ya poma yehi ni huku ya pukurura ni huku ya poma puro ya umpito shaya ya thiko tatu shini ngashike
Then Mr. Nakathingo, can you please tell us what exactly transpired in Okakodi this past weekend? Because what we understand is that several people who have been identified or people who are part of the current senior leadership of the Ondonga Traditional Authority have actually gone with police officers to intimidate community members who were gathered for a meeting in Okakodi. Has that news reached you and how is that being handled at the moment?
Well, I got the information or the information has reached me. Because I'm one of the community leaders that currently engaging in the activities that are taking place. But I cannot really go to the bottom of the situation, what really transpired. But the information came to me is that the group on the leadership of Mr. Zakaria Nepando and the police officers went to Okakodi on the information that the people of Okakodi, they are going to have a meeting. And then they informed the police or they called the police to accompany them. This is not a new abuse or misuse or misinform the police officers by this new traditional, those who are taking the power at the traditional authority. Yeah, so, and apparently they went also with a written letter, pretending or as it was written by the king. I don't know the content of the letter. We are still trying to find out or to get that letter at hand, but it's not yet in our possession. So, but that's the information we got, and the situation. This situation is still in. Between our community lawyers and the highest authorities, including the Office of the Inspector General, the Honorable Minister of Safety and Security, and the Prosecutor General. So therefore, we are yet to be informed of the outcome because our lawyer wrote in a letter to them and demanding the response within 7 days. So therefore, that incident took place as the information reached to you. That is the information we got. And what transpired is that the purpose was to disrupt this peaceful gathering, which is the violation of the constitutional right of assembly of the community members or the Namibian people.
Is this the first time that this current leadership is trying to is this the first time that they've tried to interfere in community gatherings, or is this the first time that they've tried to intimidate people who have gathered to discuss issues that affect the community in Ondonga?
As per my experience, it's not the first time, because this kind of intimidation or interruption has started just immediately after they took over the office or the traditional power, whereby I can confirm the last meeting that was invited by the community members themselves in the leadership or the assistance of the former traditional councillors. Some of them, especially Mr. Zakaria Nepando himself, was trying to disseminate the information amongst the community members not to attend such meeting. And again, I can confirm to you that this is not the first time, because there was a preparation of the community visit to the palace of Ondonga, which was on the preparation and arrangement of the community themselves, including myself as the community leader. But it was on an arrangement, you know, prevented that the king is not ready to meet with his own community, which is a strange, which came strange to us. The king refused to see his people. Because we are the community of Ondonga, they know what they're doing, they know what they want and why they want it, and they know their position, including myself. We have called off such a visit because, one, the community, the entire community, has no intention of any violation or any intimidation or any you know, to get involved in anything that to cause havoc. But it's for peace. The community of Ondonga are peaceful. It was a peaceful visit. Therefore, we say, well, let us not enter into this situation of forceful position whereby it can cause a crash anyway. So we call off the visit, and we said, well, we are going to investigate this matter, including the letter that apparently came from the king. And this is where we are now in that process, to discuss and investigate in details what transpired really, in order for us to determine our next step or action.
All right. We also understand that the community has been cut off from getting information that is usually disseminated through NBC radio. And currently, there are people that have been blocked, or there are people that are not allowed to air certain information that concerns the community on NBC radio. Why is this?
Well, I can say this again, that this is a total violation of right to information. It's a total violation of law in terms of the Namibian constitution. Because NBC is a public institution that is open to all, but people are using their position to misinform and abuse the power. So, of course, there is such preventions for the Ondonga community members not to use that platform in terms of information dissemination or to call any meeting. That cannot happen. I mean, that was prevented. So, no more watch a name, Bono, or Omika Ondono, or the Nana Tadinimba Kohandima. Opena o mapopso nga gripo taga popiwa oshiwana sha Ondonga ukwachamvuru mweka unashana nao shilonga o tuhoroleta ndo kupopsa chikenga kucha eyo shilimo njira ndo shiko nika kucha upena o shiwana shandongo shakeli waka shipikita mo yele mena ni ukashimu mbisi.
Alright, but who's the person who's behind these acts exactly? Who is the person who orchestrated for certain people to be cut off from disseminating information, therefore cutting off people in Ondonga from information that they need regarding their own community?
Well, you know, each institution have got their leaders. And NBC is not in exclusion of such institutions too that have got their leaders. So the NBC platform that was experienced to prevent the information dissemination through its radio frequencies is NBC Radio Shiwango, which we know that is under the leadership of Ms. Helen Shimbi. But one really cannot mightily blame that such institutions' leadership, because if the information that was brought to that institution was biased or was only misinformation, one can took a decision on wrong basis or on wrong information. Or sometimes the leader of such specific institution know exactly what transpired, therefore can take a biased decision or a decision which is sidelining the circumstances or the situation at hand.
Then, Mr. Nakathingo, there's another issue that we would like to touch on, and this is the allegation that there are a number, actually a very large number of cattle from the crown of the Ondonga king or from the crown of the palace that have died, but this is being hidden or that this has not been communicated to the community. What exactly is happening around that?
Yes, that information has reached us that some of the our king's cattle has died at his farm on an attempt of being stolen or made or abandoned on purpose for them to die. And such information really is not really disseminated or spread amongst the Ondonga community members on purpose to say. Because the allegation says that there are those who are trying to steal those cattle, to steal them away, to remove them away from such farm and to unknown place. As per the previous allegations that there are many cattle that gone that has vanished or get lost from the Ondonga, and those cattle belongs to Ondonga palace or lobbies, because there is Ushito Peno Ongobe to Liro Oshindonga, which Ondonga Ongobe no Odawa, he dish, Ongobe Dawa, Unquanira Teotada, Ongobe no Diri Poke, Diri Potesho, Diri Padi, or Hadithi Uruashi, or Moroa, Unquanira Teaco, Tavukong, Himunanjo, Okupito Shidongo. So imuna nezo ndakuto ya sako khamba no beuva ya nuyere ne bono wa khole kwa inofika mna na mushiwa na shike de sigo mana da tshiko na kona ngamo le kuto shike na na shani ba murwane ngo kwa changa ripo ya o na ya kutunemba yeyi mo paife mirero otafo le kuno yeyi ina akhara ini mambite ini mba ini medina jayo nenge medina jo mafekero kashita kuti unyekadi taia puerete ya otaro mithashke vina jo mkaniyo ya mwuru asho mwere mwono ipusika na asho ipusika otatu ukona kona natangu mwure kuchu shikina nasa nukokashiki otakopo mwono mwono mandatu keshi mwisho naka winji makondo. Ya, nukaro njino kaisho, nukaro oyalu nene, oyili nina ingasi nino chino mozandonga. Ya, nukaro imiabu mwale la ukatukulo katio mendele, ocho shote na natatu njike tulimo wacha.
Right. Then, what do you think, or what exactly are their intentions? What are they trying to achieve by hiding this kind of information?
Well, in any case, if there is anybody or anyone trying to hide the information, there is something fishing. And that can be, there is untruth behind such practices. Therefore, you cannot try to hide your own name if somebody asks, or if you approach anyone and say, who are you? Then you say, no, I cannot tell you my name. It's already an indication that either your approach was illegal, was not on purpose. If it is on purpose, it is on a destructive purpose. That's why you cannot hide your own name. Even in accordance of the law, even the officers, the police officer, can before he do or he and if he's going to do an arrest, he have to introduce himself. I'm Warren Zoso or Sergeant Zoso. I'm here for this purpose. So if there are a prevention or information to be hidden, it means that there is a hidden agenda. So this is the reason I saw, or we realized that, or one can say, the information was hidden on purpose because there is something that is being practiced, they know that it's uncommon, and it is untruthful, and it's illegal. Therefore, one can come to the position of hiding the information.
All right. Well, we would also like to know then, how exactly would the Ondonga community do away with all the challenges that you've mentioned that are being faced right now?
As I told you that we are in the process of getting everything on track, we believe in the truth, and especially myself, I believe in God, and whatever I do it on the power of God. And I can tell you now that the Ondonga situation shall go to rest as we speak. Not that far. Some people see that it is too far to reach, but I can guarantee you and I can tell you that it is not that far as some other people assume it. We are busy bringing the elders together, as I told you, that knows the Ondonga very well. Once those elders come together, they will only discuss four questions. And this coming together and this gathering or this purpose, it is something that is going to send the powerful message even to the other tribes. Because once we got this opportunity to bring these elders together, including the family of our kings. So we are going to reach the common understanding, because the purpose, even as we speak here, we are not labeling anyone whether we do this wrong or right. We just want to reach to achieve the common goal of peace and unity. That is what we want to do. And then the fourth question I was saying is that what transpired, what really happened? What is going on in the Ondonga tradition? What had happened? What caused these troubles? How can we achieve this amicably and, you know, without affecting any individual, any family member, or any group, but we were going to resolve this issue amicably. And we do not want somebody or anybody in the Ondonga community to point a finger to the other one. There are already some, you know, almost erupted situation to say, this one has stolen the cattle, this one stole money, this one do what. That's not our interest. and that cannot take us anywhere. So we must face the circumstances of the situation that erupted, and we resolve without questioning who did what. We say, what happened? How can we resolve this amicably? That is our aim, and that is where we are facing now. And I can tell you, we are only waiting for a certain period of time, because we are always following what is moving around the country. We have to respect the national laws, and that also affecting the community, especially now. There is the Congress that is going on, especially for the Swapo Party. But this is not a political issue. We only don't want, because the people that are going to the Congress are also from the community. We just want to see how best we can, approach this. If there is a space that we can discuss this, because we do not want this to go beyond this year. So over this year, we want to resolve it within the course of this year.
All right. Yes. Mr. Nakathingo, then with all that you have said, would you be able to say that the community of Ondonga can look forward to a peaceful leadership or a peaceful year in 2018?
Of course, I can strongly say that. And I'm only calling all the community members of Ondonga to be united and to remain united. They should not be divided. The Ondonga people, they are peaceful people. That's why our king is a very peaceful man. We should respect that. And we should not fight each other. And we should not be made to fight against each other. So we should be united. We must take this personal agenda out of our discussions or out of our common practices. And we talk unity. And this unity not only to be for Ondonga people, Ondonga community members, but for the entire nation of the Namibian people. This is what we have to do. And, the good wish is that the living God is the God for all. As per my belief, and the belief where I was raised in. So we'll transform the peaceful heart to reach the other hearts so that it can be peaceful. This is what I can say. And I can tell you that once we come together, united, we'll spend or enjoy the next year as a peaceful year together.
Right. Mr. Nakathingo, thank you very much for joining us at the village today.
Thank you very much.
All right.